This is the CX vlog. I'm Simal, a student vlogger for CX. In today's video, we're going to be talking about three different ways we can save money for college. Now, when we all have a dream school, don't we? Whether you want to go to MIT, Princeton, any Ivy League, a state school, maybe a county college, any college, right? But when you go there, okay, great, you got in. Awesome. Now you got to spend that money. You got to give that fees, that tuition. But how do you do that? Well, you got to save money. You got to start earning money when you're in high school. So when you're about to be in college, you can put that money in, right? But how do you do that? Well, I'm going to tell you three different ways you can do that. So let's get started with the first way. The first way you can do is apply for as many scholarships as possible. Now, when I say as many, I mean like 10 in a month, or maybe even 20 in a month. You can do that. It's not hard. Some of them are just giveaway scholarships. Not all scholarships are required for an essay. Some don't even require anything, just your name, your email, and it's a free sweet take, right? You can do that. If you just apply for one scholarship a month and you just wait and wait and wait and just have luck, if you're lucky, you win it. Awesome, you did it. But what if you don't win? You just wasted a whole month of nothing. Well, when you can apply for 10 a month, you have a greater chance of winning. Maybe not from one side, but maybe from another side. So you can apply for 10 scholarships a month because that is an awesome way. Now, it doesn't even have to be scholarships that you should just apply to. If you're a talented writer, a poet, a musician, or anything like that, you can go for some like contests or something. There are hundreds of poetry contests online that you can apply to, and they give you money if you win, which is awesome. If you know you're talented and you know you can do it, then you should go for it. Earn that money because of your passion, your talent. Okay, there are a lot of passion scholarships. Now, passion scholarships are such as Taco Bell Foundation Scholarship. They let you apply for your passion. So what you're passionate about, you can apply for that, which is awesome. So you get to tell what you like to do and earn money from that. That's awesome. And let's not forget about CollegeXpress. CollegeXpress offers you many, many great scholarships. Once you go on their websites, I promise you, you're going to be amazed by the variety of scholarships they have. And a lot of them don't even require essay. And they're like, they range up to $2,000 and above, which is just great. When you don't have to write an essay and earn money, why not give it a chance, right? So definitely check out CollegeXpress website. The second way you can earn money for college is do internships. Now, a lot of us start summer and you want to do an ice cream job because it's typical. We're in high school and you want to do a summer job. You want to work at ice cream shop, bakery, or something like that. Well, that's understandable. And it's not a bad way to earn money. It's actually a good way to earn money because you're learning something and you're understanding how to control that budget, right? But if you do internships are a great way to learn something and at the same time earn money from that learning. To do something very, very, it depends on what you're doing as an internship. There are a lot of internships. There are science internships. There are journalism internships. There are crazy amounts. Now, you don't even have to be 18. A lot of us think, oh, I'm not in college. Well, how am I supposed to do an internship? Well, no. You can do it when you're a freshman in high school, even maybe in middle school, like an eighth grader or something. There are for that. But once you hit high school, freshman year, you can start winning those internships. There are a lot of them, like crazy amounts of them. So you can try that out. But if you're a junior or senior in high school, believe it or not, those gates are open. You can walk past through them, and there will be a massive tons of internships that you can do. So definitely, definitely do internships because that's a great way you can earn money for college. And at the same time, when you do an internship and you put it on your college application, it's going to look beautiful. This college is going to be amazed by the amount of internships you do. So definitely try that out. Now, my third and last way of saving money for college is open a student bank account. Now, you're like, don't you have to be 18 or something to open a student bank account? Well, no. You can open a student bank account at the age of 14. At Bank of America, you just have to be 14 to open a student bank account. Now, what happens with that bank account? It's linked to your parents. Once you're 17, you can have an independent student bank account, and they don't even charge you money for that. So you're saving money, and you don't have to give them any money for the bank account, which is totally cool, right? Because you don't have to be spending any money. Now, let's say your aunt or uncle gave you birthday party money, or you get allowance money, or you get good grades so your parents give you money, or however you are earning money. You earn money from a job or internship, right? Now, you usually take it out in cash or maybe a check and put it in your parents' account. Well, and then the next day you go shopping, and here you go. You put all the cash out in your shopping. Was that worth it? No. Well, maybe you got good clothes, but was it worth it when you're applying for the college and then you realize it's $80,000? No, it's not worth it. So when you have a student bank account, you can tell those parents and your aunts and uncle to put that money, the allowance money, in your bank account. And that way, you can handle that. A lot of bank apps, they allow you to have goals. Now, what you can do in those goals is, say you want to save money for education, but at the same time, you want to buy a car when you're in college. So you do this. Go to goals. Hey, I want to save money for education, cars. I'm going to buy a house of mine. Here you go. Your goals are starting to list down. And then you say, let's do this. $10 a month for education. And then you go ahead and you put $10 down for education, $10 down for a car, and so on and so forth. And that's a great way. Now you're handling money. You're getting bank statements monthly, and you're realizing what you're spending your money on instead of taking that shopping out in cash or something and then go back to receipts and then try and see where did I spend this money. Instead, have this monthly bank statement and just see, this is where I spend this much money on. And that's a great way to realize your spendings. Now, these were my three awesome ways for how you can save for college and earn money for college. I really hope you try one of these three ways out, or maybe all of them out, right? Good luck. Thank you.
If you like this video, make sure to like and hit that subscribe button. Also, click the bell button if you want to know when the next video goes live for a notification.